Hey YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. So today, as you can tell by the title, I will be doing a Chanel unboxing. I just picked this up on August 19th, because today is the 20th. So August 19th, so I am just really excited. I've been wanting this bag for about like a week, because I just saw it. And it was a very rare bag. I'm shocked that it was still at the store a week later. Let's just get into the unboxing. It took her forever to wrap it. I really want to see how it looks. So this is just the booklet, the care package. I think there's like a cleaning cloth in there. This is like my third Chanel bag, but the other two that I had previous to this I sold because I didn't like it. And yeah, so this one I'm actually keeping because I've learned that to never sell your bags, basically, because you'll want them, you'll regret it at the end of the day. This must be the receipt. So I did buy it from the Nordstrom. This is just like their return policy info. So I have 14 days to return it, which I'm not going to. And then this was just, so I got it from the Mall of America. And then this is how much the bag cost. So with tax, I don't know if you can see that, but it came to $4,500. So the bag was originally $4,500. Sales tax was $338.63, which made it a grand total of $4,838.63. Let's just get into the unboxing. She gave me two flowers, yay. Okay, she packaged this so cute. So this must be their new wrapping, I'm assuming, or I thought it was like their perfume wrapping stuff, to be honest, but this might, instead of the white, this might just be the new packaging or the, you know, stuff. Oh, okay. It's this end. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited, guys. Like, oh, I hate tearing this up. Please. I did fine on the other side, but no wonder we heard her like tearing up like the paper, not tearing up the paper, but like grabbing so much paper. I'm so happy. And they had boxes in because there was like a shortage or something on boxes. And when I went in there, and bags, because I bought a necklace back in April. And so she was like, we finally got some in. So how does she get this in here? It's not coming. Oh, she tied it at the end. That's why. Okay, so let me just move this out. There's just more packaging. Oh, I'm so happy. Made it so perfect. Okay. And here you go. Oh. The tag is on there because they, but yeah, okay. So this is it. Oh my god, it is so cute. Oh my goodness, I'm so happy. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. So This is the Chanel Mini Classic Flap Square bag. Like I said, it was $4,500. I believe this is the, let me look up the receipt. Does not say. I believe this is part of the 21 series, if I'm not mistaken. Comes with, and it's patent. It's black on black. That's what makes it so rare. Like the sales associate said that basically he has not seen a black on black mini square in 3 years, he said, in their location. Or like in general, I don't know what he meant, either their location, but he was saying how rare this bag was. And then I asked someone that is well known in the handbag community, and she was like, that is so rare, where did you find it? And I spoke to another guy, and this was after I first saw the bag, and my mom was like, just wait and see if that's the one you really want. So basically, every day I've been calling to see if they still had the bag because I know how rare it was. Like, so, but we saw a guy have the mini rectangle on when we went to the other mall that had like carries like the other luxury stuff. So there's Mall of America and then there's the Galleria. So we went to the Galleria and I saw him with the patent black on black mini rectangle, and I was like, Mom, this is a sign, like, obviously, like, it's just a sign. So then she was just like, So I walked up to him and I was like, I love your bag, like, I absolutely love it. And he was like, oh, I just got it. And I was like, oh, what a coincidence, because I was just looking at that bag. And so, but I didn't want to tell him where, but I mean, I mean there's only one boutique in Minnesota, so. But I was like, I was just looking at that, blah, blah, blah. He was like, you should go get it because they had two price increases, which come to find out on the mini square, they only had one price increase, and that was in January. The July price increase, they didn't have it on the mini squares. I think it said it went from $3,800 to $4,500. So I was like, this would be the best investment piece. Well, Chanel is just a great investment piece in general. So I highly recommend if you're buying a bag, save and get a Chanel just because they hold their value and they're just increasing. And yeah, so, oh my gosh, just, I'm so excited. But yeah, the guy basically said, go get the bag. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna get it. But oh, so this is the chip. If you can, I don't want to pull it apart, but oh, that's the chip. Oh, it doesn't come with the, oh, I miss the authentication cards, but that's okay. Oh, that sucks. I thought I saw an authenticity card, but maybe it was this thing. Oh, I kind of liked having the card inside of it. I don't know why, but oh my god. It is so beautiful. And then the lady also showed me like a little trick you can do too with the bag. I just love that noise. Like, can we just admire this bag one more time? Like, let me put this tag up. I just gotta get scissors to cut that off because I don't want to like rip it off, but let's just get a full, the black on black chain. This is like my new favorite bag. Like, this is so cute. Sorry, this is not my normal like filming area, of course, because you know I'm at my parents' house, but her name is Coco. Literally. Or I was thinking Noir. I name all my bags, but yeah. Okay, so yeah, it's patent. He told me that it's calfskin, so it should be durable and hold up. Just make sure, of course, not to put it towards light colors because it will transfer. So, I mean, I don't really have a lot of light colored bags. I have like a pink Prada. Yeah, the rest are pretty much dark colored. My Louis Vuitton is like red, but I mean, that's on a display. I'm gonna put this one on a display. But the sales associate showed me this yesterday. How does she wrap this? She did something like, oh, I think it was it? How does she do this? She made it shorter by, I don't know how she did it. I might have to go back in, but it was something. She didn't wrap it around here. I don't know how she wrapped those, to be honest. Oh, but I could do it like this. I could do two. This bag is so cute. I could do two. And it fits my body so well because I'm really small. I'm 115 pounds, so I could wear it like this. And then, of course, long. And then she showed me another way, but I don't remember how she did it. It must have been like this. Yeah, I think it was like this, if I'm not mistaken. And this is just the shorter strap. I'm so excited. Like, this bag is so beautiful. Oh my goodness. The pocket is just everything. Oh, I don't know where my phone is, but I was going to show that I could just, like, slip my phone inside of it. Oh, wait, I'm filming on my phone. Typically, I have my camera. Yeah, basically, I could just fit my phone in it. Fits my wallet, fits everything. So, I'm really, really happy. It was worth spending. I was thinking about getting, like, a smaller bag that was, like, $3,000, which it would maybe fit my phone and, like, some cards. So I decided to get this instead, just invest a little bit more to get a bigger bag because that's what I've been running into lately. I just bought a Dior belt bag and it does not fit. It doesn't even fit my phone. Like, I stuff it in the back pocket, but like that thing has fallen out so many times. I've cracked my camera, I believe, doing that. So it's just like, what was the point? I don't know what that was, but yeah. So thank you for tuning in, and yes, go out. If you're thinking about getting a Chanel, please go out. They had two price increases. They're probably going to have one in like November, December. So yeah, make sure you make that investment. No, but honestly, like, these are pretty good investments. They've only been going up. And if you are specifically looking for this one, I will leave the information down below, like the reference number. They should have, well, of course I didn't call in, but they had one in Beverly Hills. They had one in, I believe they said Portland. And there's another one here, but now that one's gone, obviously. And Portland is somewhere else. I'm forgetting. But they had like four more, but it's been fluctuating every day. But yes, so like I said, thank you for tuning into my channel. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and see you next time. Bye.